going to take you through an introduction to publishing, and then I'm going to give you an introduction to the tools that you can use to publish your data. Okay? Now, one of those tools, and the one we're going to cover in detail today, is called the IPT, Integrated Publishing Tool. Now, I went around with each of you, and I signed you in. Well, I created an account for you, and then you were supposed to sign yourself. You guys have been introduced to biodiversity data a number of times now, okay? What do we mean by biodiversity data? What do we mean by publishing? These are some of the questions that we're going to answer in this presentation, okay? Now, a lot of these slides are borrowed from some presentations that my colleague David has made. And I love them because they include some really beautiful pictures of animals. So, this is where we're focusing. Biodiversity is nice. Concentrating on taxa. Cal also introduced all these concepts in the very first day, but just very quickly. This is what we mean by biodiversity data information. It's information for species, whether it's a specimen, occurrence, or taxa. So, this is today. What do we mean by publishing? By publishing, we mean free and open access. We mean sharing your data. Okay? Is it unclear what I mean when I say I'm publishing my data? No? Free and open access. So, let's quickly go through some of the different types. Primary biodiversity data could be vouchers or coins or species occurrences, specimens. I'm sure many of you have specimen information. Here's one example, I believe, from the Zoological Museum in Copenhagen. It could be a species observation. Are there any bird watchers in the room? Anybody like to watch birds? So, imagine you're out in the field and you see a different species of bird and you record what it is you saw, where you saw it, when you saw it. You effectively just made an observation. By documenting it, you've made an observation record. Okay. That's a beautiful species of bird. Has anybody ever seen that in the wild? No? Alright, so physical collections and observations, those are the two major categories of the current science. Taxonomic data, quickly. This is information related to species. And you can describe many different properties about a species. And there's many different ways to do that in many different languages. So, that's our focus. That's the type of information that we're trying to publish. Occurrence data and taxonomic data. Okay? Now, the next part of the introduction is just to familiarize you with a lot of the concepts, a lot of the vocabulary that you hear. Alright? So, data set, data resource, same thing. It's what we've been loading into Googleify. It's what we've had inside our spreadsheet templates. It's what you yourselves have brought with you in your Excel file. It's a collection of your records. Now, maybe some of you have done it already, maybe some of you haven't, but you need to describe what your data set is all about. You do that with resource metadata. Now, data set itself is composed of data records, just like your rows in your spreadsheet. And a record is a collection of record fields, and we can refer to fields in a number of different ways, properties, elements, concepts. These is effectively the names of your columns.
Okay.
And your vector field has a value. We refer to those as values. So here's a couple of examples. I believe I've shown this slide already in the previous presentation, but a brief introduction to the records, two types of values in the record. So here are the column headers. Now, we went over this on day one, but just to drive it home, okay? Because we're going to be really needing that all of you have this fundamental concept very clearly. In our own data, the element, the field, we can call it a number of different things, right? Briefly, for our metadata, we have a standard, and for our biodiversity data, we also have a standard. Now, the metadata is EML, and the biodiversity data is .plot. And all of you know this already, but just as a brief. There's also standards when it comes to sharing information. So, in this IPT toolkit, you're going to be sharing your data the internet. So standard access over HTTP is used to share your data. And ultimately what it is you're sharing this zipped archive called the double call archive. This is also in a standard form. And you know, at the end of this week, you will be familiar with publishing using spreadsheet templates and the IPT, and I threw specify there because you weren't sure if we were going to cover it in any detail, but so you remember this from day one. This tool was used to enter resource metadata and occurrence records. There's also different types of spreadsheet templates for taxonomic data, but the one that we used in our example was for occurrence data. And then we use a processor online to convert that into a .plot archive. Now that in itself is not in a publishable form until you put it onto the web server on the internet where it's available. Now the IPT, it basically takes care of that publishing step for you. So you can load your .plot archive into your IPT, configure it, and register it, publish it, share it.